I'm starting to think Justin Button's a masochist. Sachi is our next stop on the calendar, and unsurprisingly, the Mercs are on the front again. Surprisingly, though, Rosberg is on the pole for the second time in a row, no less. So I guess oversleeping on Saturday came to bite me on the ass. During free practice 3, Sainz crashed heavily on turn 13 and couldn't make the qualifying. Fortunately, he made it into the race, but I really don't want to be doing this every episode, so leave the crash into the race, guys.
Strange grid. It's got all the ingredients. Fantastic grandstand, cool hospitality. It's a bit like Disney World for some reason.
Only there are no princesses and you only get to watch the cool rides.
Now some of the drivers will moan. He's the big cheese of Pirelli, the man we just spoke to. Some drivers say they operate a bit like cheese, others make the most of them.
All this cheese talk is making me lactose intolerant.
Now, these ladies, the beautiful girls on the grid, now I know many of you don't like the concept of grid girls, others think it's finest traditional in Formula One. It's up to leave you to work that out. Why they put them in tea bags, I don't know. Poor girls, they're weirdest dresses.
How dare you insult glorious Russian headgear? 50 more to go until what? Spontaneous combustion? Getting a little jumpy, Valtteri? Damn straight. All glory to glorious leader Putin. And maybe Bernie. Rosberg pretends to drive a Manor. And they're off to the Russian Grand Prix and Rosberg gets a surprisingly good start. The cars get mostly trouble-free in turn 1, but in turn 2, the Red Bulls pass gas. Meanwhile, Hülkenberg spins and I can't really see what else happens because the camera changed, and after a little while, the safety car comes out. Well, there's a boring race for you. Blessed be replays. Now let's check what happened. Okay, so Hülkenberg spins and then... No! My boy, no!
What is the damage on the car, Max?
Left rear of the tire.
Okay, what about bodywork?
Well, what is Max back?
I don't see any damage.
Copy that.
So oh, I guess Max back.
A little bit the left rear of the floor, but I can't see it.
Well, shut the fuck up for a little bit! Great, now I forgot what I was gonna say, thank you! Grosjean must be really glad he signed for Haas. We're not gonna do this again, are we? Here we see a ruler with an iron fist. And sitting next to him, Vladimir Putin.
Nasser and Massa, 10th and 11th. Just what we always wanted, Martin. Those two running in tandem with each other on the course.
No, we want you to go fuck yourself and stop laughing at that all the time like you're six.
So a bit of turbulent air, cold tires, understeer, more understeer.
It's crashed again. Well, that was quick. They really do get it done. Boogity, 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 and they race after Britney's booty. Finn on Finn for the win. You get it done, you're the future. Next up, you're gonna tell me you're Batman.
My throttle pedal is broken. Advise, if it sticks, what do I do?
Pray for your life. That's what I would do, and I'm an apatheist. Kimi may be slow, but his doors are welded shut. So now the race is settling into pace, and... Whoa! Hamilton's in front of Rosberg. I guess the pace is settled. That was crazy smooth though, almost scripted. I guess he really is done for.
So Nico, just need to adapt to the situation. We'll try and let you know if there's anything else that we can think of.
How do you adapt to a stuck open throttle? Duct tape? Well, there are many reasons why that's not very convenient right now. All please rise for a 5-second silence salute for Nico Rosberg's title hopes. Maybe next year, my friend.
Okay, Lewis, the last lap, Bottas at 42.9. Gap is at 2 seconds now, so you can cut some of that fuel saving. You're doing too good a job. We can start to use a bit of that fuel, build the gap.
That's one hell of an ego boost. Hey, fancy seeing you here.
Yeah, Hamilton.
Okay, Romain, so lap time is competitive. Lap time is competitive with the other prime runner. So we are P13, it's a long race, everything can happen.
Anything indeed. That was a nasty crash, but the camera's on us! Let's wave around like floppy dolls! It seems that being behind Button stunned Grosjean to such an extent that he just couldn't help but lose control. Sounds like a good reason to me. Blessed be headrests. They pop up every once in a while and they get tossed around, but they get the job done. Gesundheit. They really, really do get it done.
I think this is the slowest the safety car's ever gone. It's
can't keep the temperature in the tyres.
Okay, copy that, Lewis. We are talking to them.
A Mainlander! Speed up, you slug fuck! He is really jumpy today. And once again, off they go. If only it was like this every race. I'm not sure whether Kimi is nice or slow. Maybe nice and slow. Damn, they're really going for the kill now. That's a really smooth transition. Casual lockup, and his troubles continue.
Guys, the tires are dying.
He's saying the tires are going.
Nope, he said dying. Crofty is both blind and deaf. Their stops may be shit, but their camera angle and oven mitts games are on point. A place for every tire in its place.
Relative to the road as well, and not just, you know, look at the front wing on that. Looks beautiful, but it also looks like a Christmas tree. It
looks more like my shaving razor. Yes, I do shave, that's why you never see anything in there. So here I am, with open doors. He passed me with grace, cause I left the space. This pit stop goes faster than you can say Alan Prost did nothing wrong. And the manor takes the lead! It's something that I wish I could say.
And Manor, we are racing Massa behind to the end.
I love your sense of humor.
So do I. Another hiring prospect for the show. Surprise, Finn. Surprise what now? You heard what I said. The Parkinson camera.
Take that.
Red Rocket.
Red Rocket versus the Stripe Jet. Who will emerge victorious? Find out in 2 minutes. Oh, snap! Oh, you're still here. That's cool, I guess. How's the Haas talks going? Oh yeah, man, I totally got it. Looky, looky, loo, baby's now in front of you. No contest. The nice man speeds past Smiley Boy. Someone tell Kimi that's not the actual line for the turn. Round and around she goes, and where she stops, nobody knows. On attack mode barrier 3 turns later, that's where. Oh, never mind, he's fine. Somewhat. Only not at all. He's being too kind, something's not right.
Oh dear. Ooh.
Okay, now it's clear, but we've got a very brave Russian running across the track.
Bravery comes with being Russian. Ah, what the fuck? It's always the nice ones. Always.
Mode 1. We've got 1 lap only. Go mode 1.
Come on now, let the underdog take this one. Look who also decided to come. Never thought I'd ever say this, but fuck you, Valtteri. And fuck you too, Kimi. Oh, Kimi Raikkonen, you blinding idiot, thank you! There's no need to fear. Underdog is here! And Lewis Hamilton wins once again in dominant fashion, inching ever closer to the World Drivers' Championship. Vettel is second, and I don't really have anything to say about him. Well, Perez is third, and I feel so great about it! Oh, and Massa is fourth, all the way from 15th. Woohoo! Patriotism!
What the f*** did he do?
No more Mr. Nice Man. Glorious leader is very smooth. Oh hell yeah, Ushankas, now you're talking! Damn it, don't drop it in front of Putin! Oh, Lewis sprayed on Putin, he's my hero now. Well, this was a better Grand Prix than everybody expected. But the track is still horrible though, so that doesn't change. Kimi Raikkonen got 5th place, except not because of the penalties, and he dropped down to 8th, and made the Mercedes World Championship, World Constructors Championship, congratulations to them. Despite all the hate, it's still good. Well, McLaren got double points, except not because Alonso got a 5 second penalty, and I'm fucking up on the lines, and now my boy is finishing in 10th, woohoo, I am so happy. Coming up next is the land of the brave and home of the free. Wait, I think I screwed it up. But whatever. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you on the next race. Oh, that's right. My expectations fell flat. That's what I wanted to say. Though now I'm kind of glad I didn't.